Good evening, how you doing? I'm Minister Peyton Moore. Today we're here with our Maximize Manhood curriculum. I'm so glad to be here today. We're going to be starting on Chapter 11 class, and I hope you all enjoyed and have been enjoying the Maximize Manhood curriculum from the book Maximize Manhood. Today we're going to be talking about the video to Dad, which is in Chapter 11. Chapter 11, the video Dad. It's amazing how the images that come from that TV screen can get into the minds of our children and other people, and they create something about us. Or you create something about someone. It's very powerful. The TV, the internet, the social media, even the music is very powerful. It's a very powerful source, and that's something that we got to be careful about. It starts off talking about Bart Simpson. Bart Simpson, this guy, this young kid here, was just very disrespectful to his father, Homer, who was foolish, weak, and he was outsmarted by his loudmouth son. Right before television viewers, it's Homer, this picture of the manhood that we want to see. I don't want to be part of that. And you shouldn't either as a man. Then you have Al Bundy on Married with Children, who was this drunk, lazy, perverted man. He's very sloppy. He thought the world just revolved around him. And he had all these ridiculous ideals about becoming rich, these get rich schemes quickly in life. Okay. And as I can see that in their perversion, these form of images of manhood is stamped in the minds of millions of people all across this world. The images in our mind create the motivations for our behavior. We become the images we have of ourselves, if we believe that, and we treat others according to the images we have of them, because we have let these images be implanted into our mind about someone else. The most powerful thing that can be done in life is to create an image. The next most powerful thing is to destroy an image. And guess what does that? The most powerful tool in the world, the television, has been creating and destroying the images of manhood for many, many, many decades. And that's very dangerous. The most powerful thing that can be done in life is to create an image. Always remember that. Our youth have been traumatized by the video daddy. And these images, like it or not, are examples of an authority figure in the home. Really? I hope that's not you, because it's not going to be me. I had to learn to step up. I had to learn to be stern and be sincere when it comes down to dealing with my children and with any of my stepchildren in the past. You know, you have to learn to let people know that you mean business. It's a time to laugh and smile, but it's a time to be sincere and mean what you say. Okay? The foolish male characters, too numerous to mention, have distorted the image of husbands and fathers. You see, these characters here have just gave men a bad name. It's bad enough that you have organizations degrading men, and you have TV shows degrading men. Okay? That's bad enough. Okay? So the mind, this image have been stamped in the mind of millions of youth all across this world, till it became the point of mockery of that man, the resentment of my father, the resentment of the person that's in authority. Here we see a story about a man who has a son. This father didn't understand the power of the images that was coming through that TV. Now, I'm not going to say he didn't, because maybe he did. On the other hand, it was his responsibility to exercise some kind of control over the images that were presented to his son. But he didn't. He allowed his son to watch any and everything on TV, play all these crazy video games, watch any and everything, and surf the social media, Facebook, TikTok, and all these other social media platforms. So, and probably these video games played a big part as well. So anytime that son saw a flaw or some type of prejudice or weakness in his father, he captivated on that. He was like, yeah, I got my dad now. He's weak. He ain't gonna say nothing to me. I can tell my dad what to do. Oh, no. That's kind of like that Homer Simpson syndrome, right? Bart, I'm in control now. Minister Peyton Moore got this. Here we go. This is why some groups fight against TV and other programming, because they notice that some of these shows, a lot of these shows that's on TV, they control the mind, especially these reality shows, which has just really gotten out of hand. A lot of these cartoons are just way out of hand. Television has distorted our image of husbands and fathers. It has distorted that. It has destroyed it. You see, men in these TV shows have become weak. They have no control over their families at all. Zero. They have no dominion. Zero. None. The children are telling the fathers what to do. The wife is disrespecting the father. So it's all messed up. And this is the image that people we see that's being portrayed in some of the homes and families. The TV, the motivation behind this programming is it's all about money. It's about the love of money, which is what? The root of all evil. You have these producers and these television corporations that say, oh, no, we don't have that much power. We don't create images for these kids and these people to see. Well, anytime that you spend $300,000 or more for a commercial, what are you doing? You're trying to present something and present an image in front of people to get them to buy the product, right? So is television powerful or is it not? The nation as a whole has been adversely affected by the video images of television programming. Ooh, the national image as a virtuous nation, a benefactor to the entire world, a savior from enslaving dictatorship, has undergone severe changes as a result of television. Television is powerful. The internet is powerful. Social media is powerful. The music industry is powerful. These games are powerful. So parents, take control. Then we talk about the heroes. The anti-hero syndrome. Wow. God hate those who say that bad is good and good is bad. God hate those who say that bad is good and good is bad. So now, the images that I see on TV, majority of them are bad. But somehow, that bad image is good. That's a good character. How is that? I don't understand that. Al Bundy is not a good character. Homer Simpson is not a good character. A lot of these reality shows are not good characters when I see these beautiful women acting like some junior high kids, snatching off hair and taking off heels and slinging wine bottles all across the table and acting a fool. That's not upcoming of a mature woman. Or you have men acting like little boys, smoking weed, popping pills, playing video games all day. And cheating on their wives and sleeping around with other women. Like, okay, it is what it is. That's the image of a man. It goes on to say, check this out. The hero image in the mind of a young man's powerful motives motivates him in life. The hero image of a young girl's mind of the man she will someday marry also motivates her. Is that the kind of image that you want your daughter to see? And she's not trying to marry a guy like that. Your son is not trying to marry a woman like that with those negative images. And if they do, that's by their choice. They deal with that. It's why parents, you have to set the example. You are the example setter. You're the one that set these examples for your children and your grandchildren. Throughout life, there is a constant adjustment of idea and the real. The distance between the idea and the real is the degree of disappointment in life. Youth, our young people, need positive role models in their life. They need positive heroes in their life. The biggest hero you can have in your life is Jesus Christ. Who died upon the cross for your sins. That's why we as men have to be Christ-like, because our children and our wives and our grandchildren and family members, some of our family members, are looking up to you to be the light. And how we do that is that by letting God renew the images in our mind. More than ever before in history, men need to recognize how God originally made them to be and earnestly endeavor to let God recreate their manhood in the image of Christ. Renewing the mind, Romans 12:2, letting God clean the heart, Ezekiel 36:26. Oh man, renewing the mind and heart, that's powerful. Come on. How can we change the negative images? By letting God renew our minds. Adam was created in the image of God, and he was the example of manhood. Jesus Christ became the second Adam, and he was the example of manhood and restored the image of man once again. We got to be born again. We can have our minds renewed and our hearts regenerated. From there, our entire life would be changed. The old things would go away. They would pass away. All things would become new. Come on. That's what we got to do, man. We got to step it up. We got to have Jesus stamped on our minds. Have Jesus stamped on our behaviors. Have Jesus stamped and our attitudes, and have the desire to become new in Christ, become new creatures in Christ. It's time for the Lord to turn the hearts of the fathers to the sons. Fathers, oh, it's time. It's time. It's time. It's time. It's time. It's time for the Lord to turn the hearts of the fathers to the sons and the sons to the fathers. Malachi 4:6. There's enough degrading men from some of these so-called organizations like Black Lives Matter. They degrade men. They're not pushing men up. They're not lifting men. They're degrading men. There are organizations out here and there are TV shows that are degrading men, making men weak, making men feel like they're just nobody. In God's eye, you are everything. You are created in the image of God because God created you and God gave you responsibility, men. Here's something that the psalmist wrote. It says, I need your help. This is what you ask God. I need your help, especially in my own home, where I long to act as I should. Help me to refuse the low and vulgar things. Help me to harbor all crooked deals of every kind, to have no part in them. I will reject all selfishness and stay away from every evil. I will not tolerate any who slanders his neighbors. I will not permit conceit and pride. I will make the godly of the land my heroes and invite them into my home. Only those who are truly good shall be my servant. But I will not allow those who deceive and lie to stay in my house. Psalm 102:2-7. So, that sounds like to me God gave every Christian father a guide to take care of the video daddy. So this is something that you read to a person that have a problem like that. Every man, guess what? Every man has three functions in his home. Every man have three functions in his home and his community, and that is to guide, to guard, and to govern. It's your responsibility as men to guide, guard, and govern. Etchol was he was a chairman of a group called the Committee for International Goodwill. And this organization here, they presented an award called the Man of the Year to the godly men, the heroes of our land. Because the world has created the ungodly as heroes, making the bad good and the good bad. If you see a lot of these people that are bad people, they became the heroes. Well, how is that? Oh, the nasty, derogatory, vulgar things that they're involved in. How are they the heroes? But the good man over here, he's being degraded. That's not fair. It doesn't work like that in God's world. You need to form yourself a committee in your home. Make the godly of the land your heroes. God says it, and by doing it, you will create a positive image in the minds of your family. And that motivates them to become right. It's a motivational thing. Because there are seducing spirits and doctrines of the devil out there. 1 Timothy 4:1. And these seducing spirits, they're nasty. You must reject those spirits and doctrines. Cast them out of your home and out of your family. You must pray. God gave you every power. He gave you a commitment. He gave you a duty to guide, guard, and govern your family and your community. The video dad also can be this person that's in the house. But guess what? He pays no attention to nothing that's going on. He's absent. The greatest addiction in America is not marijuana, cocaine, or pills. Guess what it is? It's television. It's the music industry. It's video games. It's this entertainment that's providing this negative atmosphere. The absentee father is often one who goes to work and comes home and sits in front of the television, forcing his wife and children to do his responsibility, to do his duties. Taking out the garbage. Your wife taking out the garbage while you're sitting in front of a TV? Your children is cutting the yard while you're sitting on your lazy butt? Now, I'm not saying that not to teach your sons how to cut the yard, but come on, man. So you can just watch TV all day? Are you disabled now? Are you... Come on. You got to get out of that. Here's a story that happened in Pittsburgh. Ed Cole was sitting over a cup of coffee, and this guy that he was talking to, he used to be one of those guys. He was addicted to the television. He was addicted to the television. It got to the point where when he woke up, he said, you know what? We need to put the TV in the closet. And we're only going to bring it out when it's something that's agreeable for the family to watch. Not that I want to watch, not for what you want to watch, but it's going to be a family thing. So that TV went in the closet. And guess what? It worked. Because guess what? The kids' grades started going up in school. The wife attitude changed. His attitude changed because you know why? Because now they're spending more quality time at the dinner table talking instead of watching he in the living room and she's in the other room and the kids in the back bedroom. Now, everybody's not watching what they want to watch. They're watching something that's beneficial for the family to watch that would help them, that would encourage them, that would motivate them to do better in life. Yes, 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 yes. Here's another story about a pastor, a minister, who could not do without TV. He refused to take leadership in the role of his church. He forced his wife to do it. In between his messages and in between his sermons, you know what he would do? Go in his office and watch TV. Evidently, it must have been an NFL or golf or basketball or something on that was so important. In between, you're going to... Baby, you take charge of that. I got to go watch TV. I'm through with that. I'm through teaching right now. This was a pastor of a church that did this. The best daddy is the one who uses the television to make the godly of the land his heroes. That's the best father. The best daddy is the one who uses the television to make the godly of the land his heroes. Many men believe that America is great because of its virtue, of its wealth. But it was the virtues of the American men and women who brought our wealth. Men, families, nations are great by the wealth of their virtue, not by virtue of their wealth. Men produce nations. A nation is great because of its great men and women. Okay? For America to recapture its greatness, its men must recapture its manhood. That means that men, you got to stand up. Quit being weak. Quit being sorry. Quit being lazy. You got to get up off your butts and stand up and be the man that God designed you to be, and that's to be Christ-like. Manhood is in spirit. It has nothing to do with physical size, but everything to do with his character. Modern youth need fathers of good courage. Fathers, you need to stand up. You need to stand up. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Joshua 24:15 is what you should say. Men are God's methods. While men look for better methods, God looks for better men. God is looking for them right now. He's looking for you right now. So, is it your time? So what about you? May God bless you. May God keep you. And I hope you all enjoyed this curriculum. And I love you.